Starting with the name of Allah Almighty, who is the master of the day of judgment, and a bundle of Durood Salaam on last Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Students, exercise 6A, mathematics class 7 of SAC students. And question number 3 is, there are two quadrilaterals, E, F, G, H, and L, M, N, O, and both are congruent. We have to find all the missing measurements like E, F, H, G, N, M, O, L, angle M, angle N, angle E, and angle G, we have to find. Students, if these two figures are congruent, then side EF will be corresponding side of LM, FG side will be corresponding with MN, GH side will be corresponding with NO, and EH is corresponding with LO, and angle E is equal to angle L, angle F is equal to angle M, angle G is equal to angle N, and angle H is equal to angle O. So first I will write all the corresponding sides and angles, and then we will put the values. So side EF will be equal to LM, side FG is equal to MN, side GH is equal to NO, and EH is equal to LO. So now students, find the values of EL, EF, not EL, EF is missing, but LM is given. The value of LM is 3.4, so here I will write 3.4 centimeter, and the missing length of EF will be 3.4 because both are congruent figures. Then FG is equal to MN. Now I will see that what is FG, and the value of FG is 5 cm and MN is missing. So it means that MN is 5 cm, and here I will write 5 cm. Third side is GH, and I will see which line is GH, and it is GH. It is missing. And GH is equal to NO, and the value of NO is 2.4 cm. So HG is 2.4 cm, and I will write here 2.4 cm. And then EH, I will see that which line is EH. So it is EH, and EH is equal to LO, and LO is missing. The value of EH is 3 cm, so the value of OL will be 3 cm because both are congruent figure. So I will write 3 cm before EH and LO. Now students, if both triangles are congruent, then their corresponding angles will also be congruent. So students, angle E of this quadrilateral is equal to angle L. Angle F is equal to or congruent to angle M. Angle G is equal to angle N, and angle H is equal to angle O. Students, if you understand the sequence of these two quadrilaterals that is written here, then you can easily find the corresponding angles as well as corresponding sides by the help of the sequence of these two quadrilaterals. Now look at angle E. Angle E is missing, and angle E is equal to angle L, and the value of angle L is 100 degree. So I will write here 100 degree, and it is the value of angle E, and I can write 100 degree here if I want, not 110, 100 degree. And angle F is equal to angle M, and the value of angle F is 65 degree, and angle M is missing. So I will write here 65 degree, and so the value of angle M will become 65 degree. Next students, angle G is equal to angle N, and look at angle G, and angle G is missing, but the value of angle N is given, that is 75 degree. So here I will write 75 degree, as well as at vertex G I will write 75 degree. And the last angle is angle H, and the value of angle H is 120, and angle O is missing. So this angle will be 120 degree, and here I will write equal to 120 degree. So in this way, we can find all the missing sides and angles of the quadrilateral. Friends, question number 4 of the same exercise, we have to find either the pair of triangles are congruent or not, and if they are congruent, then we have to explain the reason, and if they are not congruent, then again we have to explain the reason that why they are not congruent. So students, in the properties of congruency, I have told you that two figures will be congruent if their corresponding angles and corresponding sides are congruent. So there are two triangles A, B, C and P, Q, R, in which angle A is 36.9 degree and angle P is 36.9 degree as well. Angle Q is right angle. This square box is indicating that angle Q is right angle, as well as this square box in this triangle indicating that B is right angle. So students, angle C and angle R will be congruent because both are complementary angles of angle of congruent angles are equal angle. So angle C and angle R will be equal. Now students, I will compare that in triangle ABC correspondence with triangle PQR, and it is written as in triangle ABC correspondence with, this sign is indicating that we are corresponding both the triangles, triangle with PQR. Students, look at angle A and angle P. In the sequence, angle A and angle P both are equal. So angle A is equal to angle P. Angle B is 90 degree as well as angle Q is 90 degree. So angle B is equal to angle Q. And angle C will be equal to angle R, because these two angles are complementary angles of the congruent angles. So these two angles will also be equal. Students, we have pointed out that all the corresponding angles of both the triangles are congruent. Now we have to see that either the corresponding sides are equal or not. And if corresponding sides of the triangles are equal, then both the triangles will be congruent. So in the correspondence of both the triangles, side AB must be equal to PQ. And now we will see that either AB is equal to PQ or not. AB is equal to PQ, and look at the measurements of AB and PQ, both are equal 4 cm. And then BC must be equal to QR, so BC is equal to QR. Look at the measurements of BC and QR, both are 3 cm, means both are equal. And then AC must be equal to PR, so I will write AC is equal to PR, and look at the measurements of AC and PR, both are 5 cm. Now students, all the three angles and all the three sides of both the triangles are equal. That's why both the triangles are congruent. So it is written in explanation, all the angles and sides of both the triangles are equal, so triangles are congruent. Students, B part of question number 4, there are two triangles DEF and TSU, in which one angle of both the triangle is missing. So first we will find the value of the missing angle. So I will write in triangle DEF, sum of angles in triangle is equal to 180 degree. So angle D plus 80 degree plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. Sum of these two angles will become 150 degree. So angle D plus 150 degree is equal to 180 degree, and angle D will be equal to 180 degree minus 150 degree, and the value of angle D will become 30 degree. So I can write 30 degree here because I have found out that the value of angle D is 30 degree. So students, in the same way, in triangle TSU we will find the unknown angle, that is angle U, because two angles are given, so we can find the value of third angle by using the formula, sum of angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degree. So 30 degree plus 80 degree plus angle U is equal to 180 degree. So it is written as 30 degree plus 80 degree plus angle U is equal to 180 degree. Find the sum of these two angles and it will become 110 degree plus angle U is equal to 180 degree. 110 is plus on left side. When we transfer it to other side to find the value of angle U, this 110 will become minus and we will have angle U is equal to 180 degree minus 110 degree and the value of angle U will become 70 degree. Now students, we will compare triangle DEF and TSU, in which angle D is equal to angle T. So where I will write D, T will be written with the correspondence. So angle D is equal to angle T, angle E is 80 degree and angle S is 80 degree. So angle E is equal to angle S and angle F is 70 degree and angle U is 70 degree. So angle F is equal to angle U. Means all the three angles of both the triangles are congruent. Now we have to find the corresponding sides. And in the corresponding sides, DE must be equal to TS and EF must be equal to SU and DF is equal to TU. Now we will look at the measurements of all the sides. DE is 18.8 cm and TS is 18.8 cm. EF is 10 cm and SU is 10 cm. So both are equal again. And students, DF is 19.7 and TU is also 19.7. Means all the three sides are also equal. So in both the triangles, all the corresponding angles and all the corresponding sides are equal. So both the triangles are congruent. So it is written, all the angles and corresponding sides of the triangles are equal. So triangles are congruent. Students, C part of question number 4. Again, there are two triangles LMN and XYZ and two angles are given, and in both the triangles we have to find the third angle. So I will write that in triangle LMN, sum of angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degree. So angle N plus 65 degree plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. Find the sum of both the angles and the sum will be 135 degree is equal to 180 degree. Transfer this 135 to other side and it will become minus. So angle N will be equal to 180 degree minus 135 degree. So the value of angle N is 45 degree. Now again in the other triangles, we will find the sum of the angles of triangle is equal to 180 degree. So angle Z plus 70 degree plus 65 degree is equal to 180 degree. Angle Z plus 135 degree is equal to 180 degree. Transfer this 135 to the side and we will find the value of angle Z, and that is 180 minus 135 and it will become 45 degree. So angle Z and angle N both are equal. Now students, we will compare both the triangles in this way. In triangle LMN, correspondence with triangle, angle L is equal to angle X, so I will write triangle X. Angle M is equal to angle Y, XYZ. So we will compare, angle L is equal to angle X, both are equal to 65 degree. Angle M is equal to angle Y and both are equal to 70 degree. And angle N is equal to angle Z and both are 45 degree. We have found out the value of both the angles. Equal are both the triangles. Now we have to find their sides, and if their sides will be equal, then both the triangles are equal, otherwise they will be similar because all the angles are equal. Now students, side LM must be equal to XY. LM is equal to XY. Look at LM, and the LM is missing, and the value of XY is 4, and the value of MN is equal to YZ. The value of MN is 4 and the value of YZ is 5.13 centimeter. Means these two sides are not equal. So these two triangles are not congruent because their corresponding sides are not equal. But both the triangles are similar, that you have read in the next exercise. So we can write the statement here. Both the triangles are not congruent because their corresponding sides are not equal. So you have to write it at the end. So students, it's enough for today. May Allah Almighty bless you all the time.